Now, this is the 1, 2, 3. You have the original image, you have a later image. Now, the first two images. He is wearing the head of a mountain lion with bird feathers. This is a depiction of a Florida Indian king, a Timucua chief. The first image is from Montanus's 1671 depiction of the New World, the very first image, composed of hundreds of years of European explorers coming to the New World. The second image has been altered and diluted. It's important for people to know that the panther is indigenous to present-day Florida. He's a wildcat. As you can see, these Negro feature black chiefs roam the southeast wilderness of America. You, to wear the head of a lion, you must have high rank. You must be respected. Allegorical figure of America, depicting the indigenous people of Florida. On the left, you will see a Spanish conquistador holding a cross. He is with his troops and they are converting the indigenous people of Florida to Christianity. With Spanish crowns that they got, they were sent here from Spain to colonize and take land. Now, you will see the woman. She is the indigenous female of Florida. She is the matriarch. And whenever colonizers colonize a land, they go through the female to gain resources. She is on top of a gator. The gator is indigenous to Florida and is still represented of the territory to this day with the Florida Gator football team. With doing research on Florida Indians, it just led me to a trail of gold. My forensic work, I instantly recognized this image of a Timucua of rank. Now the first is of a dark-skinned Negro featured man. As you can see, he is a product of the Florida tropical environment. On the left, I mean on the right, is a diluted image of a Timucua. Most will see these images and think nothing of it. When you're looking for your ancestors, it can be confusing. Not many know that their true history is buried. Over time, these images have been diluted. These three images represent the Florida Indian woman in different periods of time. The first image, the woman appears to be dark-skinned, Negro feature, with curls in her hair. The second image, the female is made to look more Hispanic, or like today's stereotypical standard image of a Native American that is taught in Hollywood and public school system. The third image is complete 360. The woman is Mongolian in feature. Now, this is crazy. We know the indigenous people of the Southeast did not have the Mongoloid phenotype. This image is a complete 360. As you can see over time, these images are manipulated to hide the history. Give you an idea, just to give you an idea what the Florida woman looked like. You can see this is an image of the Timucua woman. She is wearing the same regalia as this later altar image. And you can look at the sister. This is before colonization. She was walking her short natural hair. And you know, she doing her thing. Now look at this and look at this. This is the real deal, baby. This is the authentic image of the Florida woman. This image is called The Habit of a Florida King, Roy de la Florida. And on the right, this is the image from Montana's book depicting this king. This is the first image. As you can see, they are wearing the same regalia and have the same red cap on. Now, this is the 1, 2, 3. You have the original image, you have a later image. Now, the first two images show a man of Negro features and physique. The last image is a 360 of a man of more Euro feature, and the image is whitewashed. This is the King of Florida depicted. And he is first depicted in Montana's book. But when I did the homework, the man is a depiction of the Timucua, the indigenous people of present-day Florida, Jacksonville, and the eastern seaboard of America. Now look, we're going to look deep. The Timucua were described as being dark-skinned with tattoos. Now look at this blackamoor statue in the 17th century that's basically a depiction of the Florida king. He has tattoos and dark skin. Everything. This is the information that most, the Jews, look at the tattoos. You see this with the brothers today, they all tatted up. Hey, it's no coincidence. Look real good. You see the tattoos on this fella? This is how the Timucua were described in their eyewitness accounts and depictions. This man, this blackamoor man depicted, is dressed identical as the Florida king depicted in Montana's Book of the New World. From the feather crown on his head to the jewelry, everything from the neck up down, head to toe. You have to understand, Montana's book was published in 1671 of various logs and, you know, documents and explorers who came to the New World. This statue was made in 1724. So everything was happening in the ancient world. And, you know, back then, everything happened in America. This is what was the place to be. So they would make blackamoor figurines of these indigenous kings in America that they heard about. This is no coincidence. Identical. This is what you would call forbidden information. Dug up by yours truly, Ab the Legend. Pagus Hispanorum. Now, this is the painting that led me in this direction. Because when I seen this, it was on a book called Settling of St. Augustine. And it was talking about the Timucua Indians. And that name always rang a bell because I knew those were the Florida Indians. Now, when I seen it, when I looked into St. Augustine, that's the Timucua territory, I seen these men, these representing the people of their area. And I thought, okay, these are the Timucuas. And when I looked deeper and deeper and deeper, it got deep because I'm finding out these people had a population of 300,000 people, 35 chiefdoms. The history of St. Augustine, Florida, the oldest continuously occupied settlement of European origin in continental United States, began in 1565 when it was founded by Spanish Admiral Pedro Menendez. The Spanish crown issued an asiento to Menendez, signed by King Philip II on March 20th, 1565, granting him various titles, including that of Adelantado of Florida, and expansive privileges to exploit the lands in the vast territory of Spanish Florida, called La Florida by the Spaniards. This contact directed Menendez to explore the region's Atlantic coast and report on its features with the object of finding a suitable location to establish a permanent colony from which the Spanish treasure fleet could be defended and Spain's claim territories in North America protected against incursions by other European powers. Florida Indians had a ceremony they would have before war where the chief would throw water on his warriors. The water was symbolic for his blood. Now, when you look at this image, you see them with shields. You see the brothers in the back dancing. This is the authentic, this is the real ceremony. These look like the brothers in the South today. These look like the so-called Negroes in Florida today. Now, the second image, this is a later, you know, replica, whitewashed image to depict Florida Indians. And as you can see, it doesn't go in detail as the first image. The first image is from Montana's book. And when I seen this one, it had my antennas moving. I'm like, okay, where did they get the idea? Oh, good. And then we can see they got it from Montanus's book of the New World. This is the original, and this is the, what you would call carbon copy. It's important because when you read and you look up these images, and they are talking about your ancestors, but you got to get your mind right. And when I'm showing you the original, and when I'm showing you the watered down images, you gotta understand, they are talking about your ancestors, but you got to come out of their frame of thinking where they have these, where they have you thinking these is the stereotypical Hollywood fame Native Americans. Now, these are your people, and I'm showing you what they look like. With these original images, I'm showing you what they look like, what the Florida Indians look like. What would a Timucua Indian look like in 2020? I'm going to show you what a Timucua Indian looks like in the 21st century. Now, the Timucua, they were from northern Florida, southern Georgia. They were from present-day Jacksonville. This Indian brother right here is from the heart of the Timucua Empire. His features are identical to his ancestors. Now, when you look at Florida brothers, they got the clean lineup with the locks tied up. That is what the indigenous people of Florida look like. And that is what they look like to this day. And when you look at brothers in Florida today, you see the fresh lineup, edge up, the clean lineup with the locks. That is indigenous Timucua style. They're still doing it.